स्वभाव चिन्मयानन्दं कृपापूर्णं जगत्पतिं हरिषड्वर्गजेतारं नित्यानन्दगुरुं भजे स्वभाव चिन्मयानन्दं.
It's a wonderful question. In the West, most seekers of truth have thought the channeled information published by many New Age leaders to be path to enlightenment. As decades go by, seekers learn tens of meditations and healing styles with more and more phobias and self-doubts as well. In the East, the self is put in jail of sin and shame, are controlled by off-gurus that use magic to gather masses. But you in a very short time shown the breakdown of phobias and religions. Would you speak to these three ways people take as seekers and teachers? Wonderful. First thing, nobody is responsible. Neither the gurus who are channeling some ideas and writing, the New Age gurus, neither the Western New Age gurus who bring out channeled books, nor the Indian gurus, the half gurus, what you say, I don't want to say full gurus, half gurus, neither of them are responsible for our thing. Understand? If you are waiting to be cheated, you will feel connected only the person who is interested in cheating you. You are inviting them. It's not that they are inviting you. You are inviting them in your life. One thing, I always tell people, take up only if something is straight, open, based on, supported by the tradition, supported by thousands of years of knowledge. We call it Apta Pramana. The great scriptures like Upanishads, foolproof, time tested. When there is no support or the reference or the base principles from those scriptures, then please be aware and avoid. Because many times people, when they get into delirium and fever, what they write, that becomes holy scriptures. No, really. They go into delirium and something they come out and whatever they spell out or write, and that becomes holy scripture and leads the whole world into delirious state. Delirious state. I can only give this one scale. Maybe this can guide you. That technique or that person, after you come in contact with that person, initial introduction or initial exposure, does it add intelligence, awareness and bliss to you? If these three quality, even one quality increases in you, go behind that person. Surely you will be helped. Or in these three, if you are not growing in these three, forget about him. Even if he brings fortune and wealth in your life, it will only be danger for you. It will only be danger for you. Even if he brings fortune or wealth in your life, it will be like a yakshas part. I will tell this small story on yakshas part. I love to tell this story. Understand? One guy, one barber, every day he will go and shave the face of the king and receive his salary, one gold coin, and come back. King will be waiting to see him just because of the joy this barber radiates. This guy is fully contented guy. Never asked any favor to the king. See, shaving is a practically personal service. Means every day he is touching the king. So when you are in such a close proximity, naturally you can take advantage of the nearness. But he never asked anything, radiating contentment, just fulfillment. Naturally, if you want to impress a politician, be fulfilled, he will be impressed by you. I tell you, no. These are all few things. If you want to impress a poor idiot, show your wealth, he will be impressed. If you want to impress fool, show your knowledge, you will be impressed. If you want to impress a politician, show your contentment, he will be impressed. Because that is what he does not have. He has everything. He has enough cunningness, enough display, enough of all qualities. You can't display anything and attract attention of politician or inspire, influence him. You can impress him if you show your contentment, fulfillment. That is the way Buddha influenced all the politicians of India. During Buddha's time, there was not a single guy, single king who did not become Buddhist. Practically, 90% of the king, India became Buddhist. Because of the contentment he was radiating. And he was just showering or expressing through his being. The whole group of politicians became his disciples. So this guy, for him, this barber is almost like a little Buddha. Every morning he feels seeing him is an auspicious thing. He will be waiting to see. And never ever the barber asked for pay raise. Suddenly, 1 week continuously, the barber's face was not so contented, so peaceful, so fulfilled. First thing the king asked is, did you get the golden jar from Yaksha? The barber was shocked. He said, yes sir, how do you know? Then king tells the story. Listen here. I'll tell you the story, what the Yaksha would have done. You would have been walking under that particular banyan tree. Some of these banyan trees are the place where gods and yakshas both come and sit. And you would have heard the voice, do you need money? Gold jar filled with golden coins. Yakshas, the barber said, yes sir. Did that voice show you a particular place below the tree and ask you to dig? He said, yes sir. When you dig, you saw the big jar almost full. He said, yes sir. Then what did you do? Then he said, now I will tell you the story, what I did. I took the jar to the house. I saw it's almost full. Only few coins are needed to fill it. So, I thought one day I will not spend the coin which I took from you as a salary. I put it in that jar. Just I wanted to have a jar filled with golden coins. Now some 10-15 coins are less. So I put the coin in that. That day, we both of us managed from our savings, whatever we had. Same way, for few more days, we just put the coins. How many days I put the coins? Again, I see the jar is not full. There is little emptiness. What to do? Suddenly I saw my wife has become very angry with me. Because I am not allowing her to use the money and my kids are angry with me. Now I am caught in the rut. One side my desire to have a full jar of gold coins. The other side I have to fulfill my regular responsibilities. Then king said, understand, just now go and tell that Yaksha, please take your jar back and get rid of it. I also had the jar once. And I am not returned that jar. That is why I am king. Understand? That is why I am king. You return the jar and be as an old person. I love, I envy your status. I envy your state. That is why every day morning I wait to see you. Somehow I neither had maturity and now it is too late to return. One guy says, by the time I found out I have nothing to write, I have started writing books. After some time, suddenly I found out I am nothing to write, I am not that intelligent to write books. Other guy asked, did you stop? No, by now I have become too famous. So by the time the king gets the clarity, he has to return the jar, only then he will be contented. The kingdom is created. He is already in the rut. He can't come out. He can't escape. That is the one worst thing. You can't get out of that rut. You are cut once for all over. I have seen. At least in India, many politicians at some time, some way, by mistake or by accident, when they see some enlightened beings, something clicks in them also. Because of their experience and feeling of the unfulfillment, something clicks in them. I myself have seen personally, when I tell them, "Arey, then why don't you start turning your life into a new direction?" He says, "No, Swamiji, now if I step down, either I'll be put in prison or killed. I have to play this game till I die. Because I created already enough of enemies. Already I created enough of enemies and enmity. Whoever is unfulfilled or dissatisfied when I was in the power is waiting. Now I have to at least maintain a certain level of power. At least I will not be taken revenge. I cannot just completely quit and retire. The moment I retire, I'll be finished." So it's like a game. King says, "Yes, now it is too late to return. Please, you don't get caught in this mess." And king says, very beautiful word, "Your head is that Yaksha's golden pot. How much you put, it'll never be filled." Understand? How much you put, it'll never be filled. Go and return to the Yaksha, your head. The unfulfillment. See, anything you put in your head, you will see. It will take it for granted. Anything. The moment you have it, the head will take it for granted. When you came to this country, you would have had the list of having one house, one car, one family, and certain bank balance. All that would have happened in 3-4 years. But now, you don't celebrate about, you achieved that goal. You took it for granted. And now the Yaksha's head is working. The Yaksha's part is working. I tell you, at least return the head. You don't have to return the part, but return the head. Person who is filled with that kind of greed will naturally be suffering with Yaksha's part.